Hello folks, this is my beautiful IBM Selectric II, not any Selectric, a Selectric with the correcting button right here, and otherwise known as the golf ball typewriter. The original Selectric one was unveiled in 1961, and it was a true revolution. It achieved like 80% market penetration. And this one is in 1970, the Selectric 2 is 1971, the Selectric 2 with correcting button is 1973. And it is entirely mechanical. There is no electronics on it at all, like 2000 parts and a million adjustments. And the guy that invented this must have been friends with the guy that invented the helicopter. It's a completely unintuitive design that shouldn't work, but it does. Works very well. So a little bit of work on that one. The tab doesn't work. The carriage return is sluggish. Actually, my beloved correcting button is not working, and my head is a little bit of out of alignment. So we'll take a peek inside and try to fix it. Now, taking this apart is a piece of cake. If you do it in the right order. First, you need to put the carriage in the middle. Then open this up. This goes forwards, this goes backwards. Two thumbs on these levers. Button goes away. Don't forget to take that piece out. And also to flip those levers up. And inside, there are two levers, and you push them forwards. One, two, and if I have not messed up, that should do it. There it goes. And then there's one more lever on the side here that you pull forward, and that allows you to raise the machine and slide it forwards, and then flip it up. And voila, you're ready to work on your IBM Selectric. So how does this magnificent beast work? It does print by controlling the spin and the tilt of the ball. So there are two bands here, one here and one there. And if I pull on them, you can see the ball turning a bit here. And the other one that should do the, you can see it, does the tilt. So mine is cocked to the side, so I have to figure out which arm moves this. And it's attached to this guy over here, and there's a turnbuckle, so it should be fairly easy to adjust. By the way, this thing is of mind-boggling complexity. Here's a summary. Adjustment manual, and these are all the adjustments you can go through, and there are pages upon pages upon pages of this thing. Like it's 100 pages, and that's just the concise form, right? There is, and then you look at the mechanism in there. It just keeps going and going and going, and the guy that invented this was completely crazy. So now I just have to work on my sticky tab key. The return is not that good either. It's sticks. Well, here we go. Oh, because the tab is sticky, sticks a bit. It's working again. Tab is fine. That was the toughest one to repair. That was the sluggish carriage return, and it turns out it's these guys over here that have to be adjusted properly. First, there should be no oil on this one because it grabs the axle that does the carriage return. And of course it was based with grease, so I cleaned it up. And these guys you have to adjust, and that's the torque limiter. And you have to pull this tail here back a little bit to increase the force. Right, I have made real progress here. The whole thing prints, and then I can go back and erase things. So my autocorrect works again. Is it 12? No. It seems to work plenty fine. Oh, see, make mistakes.